our discussion with the new subject, that is digital image processing. So why this kind of a subject is there in the curriculum? As we know, in analog communication, as we know in digital communication, we have to transfer the media through channels and all. Nowadays we are using multimedia devices there, as a camera, and we are creating images, videos and all. So we also have to process that data. What exactly is there inside the digital image processing? We have to process that image on various background. For example, we have to compress the image, we have to further enhance the image, we have to process the data of that image. How any image is going to get transferred through a communication channel, how we used to compress any image by using a compression algorithm and all, what is image segmentation and all. So multiple points are there in this subject, that is image processing. Okay, but before starting the subject, we have to know about the basic things of that image processing. First, we have to know, when we want to process any image, if we are going to watch any image, we are going to zoom that image, every image is going to get created by using the pixels. But when we want to process that image, we first have to convert that image into a different form. For example, we can represent that image into a mathematical form for further processing, compression and other things. Okay, so how to represent that image in a mathematical form is what we are going to watch in this today's video lecture. So first we are going to start the discussion with image representation. So what is image representation? The image is 2D light intensity function given by f of x. It is centrified in both spatial coordinate as a brightness. What it means, f of x comma y is nothing but a mathematical representation or two-dimensional representation of any image. Whenever we used to zoom any image, we know that the image is what created by using a pixels. Each pixel have their different intensities there. What it means, we have, if we think about the image have a two-dimensional view there. What is the meaning of two-dimensional view? We have a coordinates there, that is x coordinate and y coordinate. So we can mathematically represent that image as a f of x comma y. And this image should lie between 0 to infinity. What it means, the intensities of that pixel lies between 0 and infinity. So mathematically we represent the equation, that is 0 is less than equal to f of xy is less than equal to infinity. So it need to be lie between 0 to infinite level. Okay, so as we know, f of xy is the arrangement of any image into a mathematical form. Xy says that it is a coordinate of an image where f represents the image. But how any image is going to get created? How this f of xy is get created? So f of xy is ultimately equals to r of xy into I of xy. Now question arises here, what is r of xy and I of xy? So r of xy is nothing but the reflectivity of a surface of image. It is a reflectivity of surface of an image. We are going to discuss about it in detail in further videos, but here you just have to understand it is a reflectivity of a surface of image point. Consider any image point or any image pixel is there, and its reflectivity represented by r of x, y, where I of x, y represent the intensity of the incident light. Whatever light is incidenting on that, the intensity of that light is what represented by I of x, y. So when if we multiply r of x, y into I of x, y, ultimately we are going to get the image function, that is f of x, y is nothing but the mathematical representation of your image, two-dimensional image. Same here, we have a coordinate, that is x coordinate and y. On this both x and y coordinate, we have this point. This point have intensity and reflectivity, that is given by f of x comma y. So how to know this point? What is the meaning of this point? We can understand by knowing this diagram here. Whenever we think about any image, we have a coordinate. So this image have a coordinate, that is y coordinate and x coordinate. On y further video we are going to understand about sampling and quantization of image. Okay, but here we are just thinking about how we are representing the pixel values. Okay, so here at a position 1, x coordinate 1 and y coordinate 1, we have here dot. Okay, so the dot is nothing but the intensity of your pixel. Okay, so same portion is what we can write mathematically. We can arrange this portion mathematically in the form of a matrix. How we are going to represent that? We know that on a x-axis we have multiple portions there, multiple coordinates there. On a y-axis we also have a multiple coordinates there. So we can arrange these coordinates according to the arrangement, and we can present it mathematically. So f of x is what, nothing but the image. In that f of f function, we have to mention the intensity of a pixel. Maybe inside it, your image, multiple pixels are going to be there. So first position, the first position pixel is on 1. Here on a x coordinate, its position is 1. So we are ultimately going to write f of 1, 1. It's the first pixel position. After that, f of 1, 2 is the second. Okay, it's a row and column arrangement of a pixel intensity. What? Pixel intensity. Okay, so it is going to further toward f1, n. So we can, it is going to be infinite. How much your image is there, the much is going to be the pixel intensity. The variation in the pixel intensity, row wise and column wise, is equal to f of 2, 1, f of 2, 2, and f of 2, n. Same at bottom, if you have to think about the bottom pixel intensity, then f of m, 1, then f of m, 2, f of m, n. It is in the infinite order, right? Because arrangement is what lies between f of x, y. Intensity should be greater than 0 and less than infinite value. So this is nothing but the first video lecture of digital image processing, where we have understand how to